How's it going, everyone? This is Kevin. Today I'm going to bring you along with me to show you the behind the scenes of how I created this fake Nike ad commercial. So let's jump right into it. So we're here in my room kind of just creating a little bit of a scenario of how to make the shoe kind of float. I'm not really sure how it's going to play out because I don't want to use like a green screen or anything like that, and I didn't want to use fishing wire because I didn't feel like going to the store. So I am using basically this tennis string from Babolat because I play tennis and I do a lot of tennis, obviously. They're one of my sponsors for my tennis academy, and so I have the string around and I thought, it's black, let's do it. Boom, let's try it out. And so far it seems like it's gonna work out, so we'll see how it turns out whenever I start doing all the filming and the editing part of it. Basically, you have already seen the video of how it turned out, so more than likely it worked. And if it didn't, I probably changed it up, but we'll see in a bit. So I have my light set up. I have one light over here, one light back there, and I did turn on the lights of the ceiling just to kind of add a little bit of extra light just so that I think it suited right. I'm gonna show you what it looks like behind the camera. I'm gonna kinda show you. This is for a photo that I was trying to take. So basically I can kinda take out the wire and post. I'm just gonna try it out and see how it turns out and then go from there. So we're gonna be using my Tamron 70-180 right here with the Sony a7 III and take the video. So I had the tennis string just loop through the shoe so that I could get some footage of it just floating, and then I can mask it out later in post. So I just started flipping it around as much as I could so that whenever I would let go, it would rotate on its own, just to have that effect that it's, you know, in suspended air and just floating around. And that way I could just edit it in post to make the little rotation that I had at the beginning of the video. After that, I just made sure to move the shoes away from it. Since I had it in manual focus, I wanted to get some footage of the background itself, so whenever I mask it out, it looks the same as it would look whenever I had the shoe on there, and it just flows a little bit better in my opinion. All right, so we're done basically taking the video of it. I'm gonna piece it together and see how it turns out. So I'm gonna go into my computer and see how I can edit it and show you how it looks just with the shoe. And yeah, we'll see how it goes. So we're gonna go a little bit and dive into the behind the scenes and show you a little bit of how I shot some of the more movement of shots with the help of my wife. So I'm gonna go over those and show you what we did. So here we have the stairwell where we kind of did that one shot after the animation that I did at the beginning. I kind of wanted to have it where it was just that one step to then move forward and start going into basically the movement of the video. My idea was originally just to have a little bit of the side view of just a shoe every time, and I also wanted to test out here. I wanted to see, oh hey, maybe I'll have something from the front to see how it'll look as well, because I know I wanted to take something from the back as well, so I want to see if it would look good in this scenario. But I don't believe that I ended up using this footage anyway. I just kind of wanted to see how it turned out. That's the beauty about planning your shoots. Sometimes they don't go as planned and you just gotta improvise and see what works best. So I have my wife here using my gimbal and just following me along because I just wanted to obviously showcase the shoes as we're going along somewhere, just because it's the main theme of the shoot was just comfort and style to create basically your content as a creator. You go to all these places and you wanna also be comfortable. So here I kind of was showing her some of the ideas that I wanted to do, I guess. I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do, but I just wanted to see how it would work with the gimbal since I have a little bit of an older one and my camera's a little bit somewhat heavier for it since I have the Zion Crane V2. It's a little bit older, so it's not as fancy as the new ones that just came out, but it does the job just fine. So we just kind of went ahead and just shot whatever we could just to give ourselves, you know, more footage to have to choose from and just make sure that we have everything covered for when we do the final edit. So yeah, that's basically just what we did. Just had her kind of go about it a couple times and that was just what it was. Here, I wanted to have a little bit more focus on the shoes to come up for the ending shot where she would kind of follow me up, and then I would take the photo and then end with the Nike logo and everything like that that I wanted to do. So overall, I mean, I like how it turned out, and I thought it was pretty cool for such a low budget little bit of an ad. So basically, that's basically the behind the scenes. Nothing crazy. I mean, we just kind of went out and shot. I just had a little idea. I wanted to go create it, and that was the best thing about it. And some people just hesitate too much just to execute their idea. So for me, don't hesitate, just do it and just have fun with it. That's what we did. I mean, hey, Nike, if you want to hire me, I'm more than happy to do an ad for you guys and put even more effort and do whatever you guys have creative, ideas. But I like to have my own creativity when it comes down to ads. So I try to do my own spin to it and just have fun with it. So yeah, that was basically my idea when it came down to just shooting this little ad commercial for a Nike shoe that I had gone that I really liked. I just had the thought about it whenever I got them, and I dropped it down into my little notebook that I have for ideas, and just kind of, I guess, did a little storyboard in it and just picture what I wanted to do. A lot of things change, but that's what you do a lot of the times when it comes down to shooting. You just improvise a little bit as well. You have a little plan and you might deviate a little bit from it, but overall you have some sort of idea that you want to execute and have a message across. For me, the message was having to create with comfort and style, because Nike provided these cool shoes that have great support, and then you can be out and about creating your content that you want to create and just have fun. That was my theme, that was my idea, so that's something that I wanted to portray, something that I was just, wanted to do, and I thought it turned out pretty great. I don't know, what did you guys think about it? Did you like the ad? Let me know down below. I would appreciate you leaving a nice comment, and any constructive criticism is always welcome here, because I love learning and I love pushing the boundaries from my skills and trying to just get better every single day. But with all that said and done, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to like and subscribe, share this video with a friend, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. See ya.